Brown and Carmichael.
Definitely Carmichael.
He didn't do so hot on the swim test.
Yeah, but Brown's gonna wash out.
You think?
No doubt. Go! Brown's from the air cab. He's only Ranger qualified.
Is that so?
Indeed.
Go! Schoolhouse Ranger. That ain't good. Oh. Blue stick. You all right?
Soldier down!
Soldier down!
Soldier down! Soldier down! Soldier down.
Wake up. Come on. Alona. Come on, wake up. Come on, Alona.
Where's your boy?
It's okay. Stay still. Stop! Stay still. It's okay. What month is this?
November.
And what are you doing here?
I'm a translator. I'm going to translate.
Going to?
I already translated.
How long have we known each other?
2 days.
And who am I?
My hip is broken, not my head.
Too tight?
Oh.
You hurt anywhere else?
It hurts everywhere. You have blood on your face.
It's nothing.
Nobody knows where we are. I did as you said at the airfield. I gave them the wrong destination.
I don't know. My people know we're here.
You radioed them?
Yes.
To tell them you were returning early.
Yes.
I remember you started to radio them. And then the helicopter went down. Are you sure the signal went through?
Mayday, mayday, mayday. This is flight 3-1. We've crashed in the northern Koryak Mountains. There are 2 survivors. We need medical assistance. Over. Mayday, mayday, mayday. This is flight 3-1. We've crashed in the northern Koryak Mountains. There are 2 survivors. We need medical assistance. Over.
In my bag, I have a cell phone.
It's gone.
Are you sure? It's very small.
Trust me. All our gear is gone. All we have left is this knife, my sidearm, and some headphones. And whatever you've got in your pockets.
I have a bus schedule.
It's paper. I'll take it.
Andraje. Can't be. Here.
No, thanks. Save it for later.
Did you do something up there?
Did I do something?
In the helicopter. When we were flying.
I don't understand. Was it something that I did that brought the helicopter down? No, I was fighting to keep it up.
Why did we crash?
From the moment it comes off the assembly line, all that machine wants to do is kill you.
Like camping. Do you camp where you're from?
No.
I hate camping.
Well, then we better get you out of here.
Will we?
Most absolutely. Here.
No, it's okay.
Day, 2 months, or anywhere in between.
Colonel Napo told you that?
Uh-huh.
And you can't wait a week for Serena's birthday?
I'm supposed to report at Fort Griffith at 0600 hours tomorrow.
And Colonel Napo didn't tell you what you were trying out for?
Nope.
He must have given you a hint.
Kim, you know everything I do. Where's my kit bag?
But that's crazy. What if it's some sort of suicide squad?
Well, then I'll respectfully withdraw.
And law school?
Well, the world is always going to need lawyers. It's just on hold a little longer.
Found it.
Yeah? Thank you.
You want to do this?
April said I'd be perfect for it.
That doesn't mean you have to go.
No, I don't have to go. I want to go.
Because it's a challenge.
Well, yeah. Hey, don't be upset.
I'm not.
Look, if I get accepted, we can make the decision together.
And law school?
What?
And law school. You never wanted to go. That's true, right?
I thought that it would make you happy.
Baby, you ain't gonna make me happy making yourself miserable.
Look, I might not even get into this unit.
Yes, you will. Because the man I married has never, ever not gotten what he set his sights on.
All you boys about to learn something new in the next couple days and weeks. Can anyone guess what that is? State your name, rank, and company.
Sergeant Robert Edison, Charlie Company, 1st Ranger Battalion, sir!
Oh, the wide world has heard about you, Sergeant Edison. You hold the speed record for rappelling in your squadron.
Yes, sir!
And I see your partner in the best Ranger competition back there, Sergeant Carmichael.
Boy, sir!
You two play second in the games last year, ain't that right?
No, sir.
We won. My apologies. What do you think you're going to learn here, Sergeant Edison?
How to be the best soldier in the United States Army, sir!
Wrong. Take your seat, Sergeant. Anyone else? What you will learn here in selection is failure. I know what you're thinking. That lunatic Ryan has no idea who he's talking to. but let me assure you I do. You may be the belle of your battalion and the homecoming queen, but we got... How many we got going through this time, Sergeant Major?
122.
122 of you handpicked for this round of selection. All of you the most likely to succeed. You remember Sergeant Danvers?
Sir, I surely do.
Why don't you tell these boys about Sergeant Danvers?
Danvers came to us after serving 3 years in the Rangers, 5 years Special Forces, multiple combat medals, including the Distinguished Service Cross. He washed out his second day here.
And we had such high hopes for him.
I met them as once.
You! Stand up, will you?
Sir!
What were you saying?
I was told, sir, Sergeant Danvers was never the same after he failed selection.
That's because we broke his heart. 122 of you. And I'll dress up like Bambi if 8 of you make it through. Hell, if 6 of you pass muster, I'll dress up like Bambi and his mom. Tell him why it's so hard, Sergeant Major.
Because it is our job to make you fail.
You heard him. Don't weed out the weak. This is not a training course. So here's your handy guide. Everything you do is an individual effort. You will assist no other candidate. You will not accept assistance. Daily instructions will be given. Pay attention! Read nothing into the instructions that is not stated. Those of you who fail to live up to core standards will be removed. If at any time you no longer wish to continue with the selection course, inform a cadre member of your desire to withdraw. You will immediately be returned to your parent unit. Questions? Have a good one.
That's the best you can do? Hell, my 9-year-old grandma can move faster than that, and she's dead.
Must be a mistake.
There's no mistake, soldier.
But I don't understand why I'm being dismissed.
Failure to meet the prescribed time standard on a 2-mile run.
But you haven't told us what the time standard is.
Well, they'll tell you on the bus ride out.
Instructed to carry 40 pounds of your ruck. As far as I can tell, your ruck's empty. Today's your lucky day, because I have that 40 pounds right here. You can carry this and your ruck for the rest of the day. Yes, sir!
Blue 6, red 2. Show me what's in your ruck. Wait. Blue 6, what were today's instructions?
Formation, no 600 hours, uniform. Boots, fatigues, 40-pound rucksack, meals, 1 MRE.
Stop. Repeat that last instruction.
Meals, 1 MRE.
Did you think that meant 1 MRE for the entire day that we're trying to starve you?
Yes, Sergeant Major.
Red 2, have you understood the instructions?
Yes, Sergeant Major.
Would you explain them to the other candidates?
1 MRE for each meal. Breakfast, lunch, and dinner. That's 3.
Well, you're wrong, Red 2. And you're out. Blue 6, you may proceed.
Mayday, mayday, mayday. This is flight 3-1. Over. Mayday, mayday, mayday. This is flight 3-1. Over. I think I found a signal.
You can talk to the airfield?
No, it won't reach. There's not enough power, but I think we can reach something closer, like a plane flying overhead. Okay, look. If you see a plane, push this button and talk. Okay? Practice a couple times. Just don't touch any of the knobs.
Where are you going?
Going for higher ground.
Why?
So I can see where we are.
Mister, a cold sore, you keep coming back. I thought we cured you.
Took quite a spill there, son. Can you sit up? How do you feel?
Okay. That's a shame.
Do you require medical attention?
The cut's pretty bad. You might need a few stitches.
Okay.
Is that what you want? See a doctor?
Uh-huh. So you're requesting a medical withdrawal, is that correct, soldier?
You can have immediate medical attention, but if you do, you formally withdraw from selection. You understand me?
Yeah.
Yes, you're withdrawing?
No, I want to stay.
You're dying, son. Wise move would be to withdraw.
I want to stay. What are these?
Stereo strips. Hold your chin together.
In case you haven't noticed, you're still on the clock. You got an 18-mile road march to complete.
In the world is in Buenos Aires. True story.
Blue Six, check in.
Roger, Blue Six. You want us to lay a cold one on you?
Sure.
How do you like your burgers?
Medium rare.
Thought you said you wanted a beer. You voluntarily withdraw from selection right now. You're welcome to join the party. You want to stay? Keep going another 30 meters. Another cadre member will give you instructions.
We'll need the boilers. Get the fire going.
What's wrong?
I just bruised a rib.
I was thinking this might make a great story one day. Are you married?
No. No, you?
Yes. Georgie. And we have son, Ivan.
How old?
He just turned 6. We had a party for him.
Mayday, mayday, mayday. This is flight 3-1, over. Mayday, mayday, mayday. This is flight 3-1, over.
Did they hear you?
Mayday, mayday, mayday. Is anyone there?
Some more firewood and try to find me some food.
Wait a minute. If you have to go for help.
You think I'm just gonna walk off? Or do you need some privacy or something?
I'm afraid I'm keeping you here.
I'll get over it. Best plan is to stay near the crash site and wait for rescue. It's not a good idea to leave unless you know where you're going. You choose the wrong direction and you're dead.
You are now entering a combat zone. You must each seek out and eliminate 6 hostiles. You have 8 rounds. Go. No enterprise is more likely to succeed than one concealed from the enemy until it is ripe for execution. Red 4, who said these words?
Machiavelli.
Blue 6, who is Machiavelli?
A statesman and political philosopher in Florence.
When?
15th and 16th centuries.
You're in hostile territory, on a mission. You come across an old shepherd. You cannot leave him behind because he may compromise your position. Do you take him along with you? Tie him up or kill him.
Kill him.
Tie him up.
And one of your teammates wants you to kill him.
As I said, tie him up.
Move on. This is a weapons assembly test. In front of you, you have parts for 5 guns. Use all the parts. Assemble them as quickly as you can. Go.
Stop. Time. Remove your goggles. Red 4, something wrong?
No, but...
But what?
Well, I have 5 guns, but I have parts left over.
And what might you think that means?
I don't know.
Did you make a mistake during assembly? Did you forget some pieces, perhaps? Are you confident that you assembled 5 guns correctly?
I believe...
Did you assemble the guns correctly, yes or no?
No.
Blue 6, how many weapons did you assemble?
7.
And why did you assemble 7 guns?
You told us to use all the pieces.
You were told there were 5 guns.
There are.
Then how did you take 5 and make 7?
With respect, sir, add 2.
Green 1, red 1, blue 6, you may proceed. Everyone else, report to out processing.
I'm lost, man. You gotta take it as crazy rap. Hey, come on, there's no one around.
Give me a map.
All right, look. You're right here. Walk along that ridge 2 clicks, you'll come to an abandoned well. Head due west.
Try this crisscross around this terrain. Here's a damn road. Hey! You have any food left? I wouldn't ask, man, but I'm dying here. Oh, yeah. Thanks. I owe you, man, right?
Good luck.
You gotta be kidding me, man. I pinned down and tried to climb up. Ah, it's too slippery. I can't get any traction. Push it or something, man. Come on. Yeah. It's too heavy. heavy. I gotta go for help.
No, we're both gonna get kicked out, man. Just pull, and I'll push.
On three. One, two, three.
Wait, I think it's moving.
Too heavy.
Go for help.
I voluntarily withdraw.
You sure? Yeah. Say whatever you need to protect yourself, man. No reason you should get punished for helping me.
Look, hurry, man. I don't want to drown out of here.
The rain has stopped.
Set more traps tomorrow. And don't worry. I'm sure there are a lot of people out there looking for us right now.
Why did this happen?
Why is a crooked letter? Nobody ever got it straight.
My poor husband and son. What would I give to see them again?
I understand.
No. If you're not married, you can't.
Yeah. I'm married. I have a family.
Before you said
to me. I know what I said before.
What's your wife's name?
Kim.
Do you have any children?
I have a 6-year-old daughter and a baby boy.
If we get out of here, I would very much like to meet your family.
Mm-hmm.
And you could meet Georgie and Ivan.
We'll all get together and we'll have a picnic.
I'd bring a covered dish.
You've been doing your homework.
Steven.
Mm-hmm.
I can't feel my hands or feet anymore.
Six.
Roger, Blue Six.
Pruitt. Green One. He's hurt.
Where?
On the ridge. 20 kilometers back.
What happened?
I don't know. He's trapped. Pinned his foot under a tree.
Alone.
Alone. You have hypothermia. I need you to stay awake. Can you recite something, huh?
What?
I need you to recite something for me, a poem or something. Okay? All right, I'm gonna go get some more wood and set some more traps. I'll be back before that fire is out. Let's hear it, come on.
Велика є велика свин.
You passed Sergeant Pruitt on the course. Did you speak to him?
No.
Then what?
We both moved on, and it started to rain. After a couple minutes, I looked back to see where he was, and he was gone.
Why?
Why?
Why'd you look back?
I couldn't tell you. Instinct, I guess.
Were you concerned for him?
No, not then, anyway. I got worried when I looked back, and I couldn't see his VS-17 panel.
Because? Pruitt's a top ranger. Didn't you think he might be over the ridge already?
No, that was unlikely.
Why?
When I passed him earlier, he seemed exhausted.
How could you tell?
He looked that way. Why? What did Pruitt say?
What he said is irrelevant. So you were concerned. Then what?
I went back to check on him.
To offer him assistance.
To see where he was.
And that's when you found him?
Trapped under a tree, yes.
And then what did you do?
I ran to the RV to get you.
Just got word from the hospital. Sergeant Pruitt's dead. Did you or did you not offer assistance to Sergeant Pruitt?
I did.
When?
When I passed him on the course and again when I found him trapped.
Why'd you lie about it? You lied about it to a cadre member. Why?
Because it is against the rules of selection to offer or accept assistance.
Knowing you violated the rules, why'd you leave a man to die?
I didn't leave him to die. He didn't look that bad. I left him to go for help. I ran all the way to the RV.
Seems he did. Finished within the time standard.
That's impressive. You completed your mission. But you left a man to die, which makes me wonder, Sergeant Brown, are you always so selfish?
Pardon?
Seems your desire to be in this unit led you both to lie and to put the completion of your task above the welfare of another soldier. In my opinion, Sergeant Pruitt's death is your fault.
He didn't look that bad.
I'm sure his widow is going to be thrilled to hear that. What do the other boys say?
According to the report, Candidate Brown is not held in high regard.
Huh. Seems your peers think you're a piss-poor soldier. How do you like that?
I'm the best soldier of the bunch, and they can kiss my ass.
Knowing Pruitt died, would you have changed your actions?
No, sir.
I'll ask you that again. Knowing the results of your actions, would you have acted differently?
No, sir.
No, sir, you don't care about selection?
Yes, sir, I do.
But what?
But I had a mission to complete, and I completed it.
You're one cold-hearted snake, son. What do you say to that?
No excuses, sir.
And you admit you left a man to die?
They taught me at Ranger School that my first responsibility is to complete my mission. The second is to protect my team. If I cannot do both, I will complete my mission.
You think being a Ranger in Ranger School is the same thing, son? What if I told you because of your mindset, you're out of selection?
If that's what you're telling me, then fine. I'm out.
Elona. Elona. Elona, we're leaving. I built a radio receiver. I picked up a local radio signal.
You should stay here. It was the best idea.
Yes. Yes. It usually is. Unless you know which way to go. All right, now. I have to move you, okay? So, put your arms around my neck.
Can't.
Hold on. I know.
It wasn't your fault.
But they can still charge me with contributory negligence.
Which is ridiculous.
Not to the Army.
Well, I wouldn't stand for it. This is completely unfair.
A man is dead, Kim. Try telling his wife how unfair it all is.
Look, I'm not trying to be callous, but you did everything you were supposed to do to save him.
That's irrelevant.
And look how they made you doubt yourself. The truth is, they killed him by what they put him through.
Perhaps.
There's no perhaps about it. Would you do anything differently now?
No.
Well, in that case, if this is something you still care about, go back and fight. Fight to be reinstated.
What's on your mind?
I've been screwed over, and I think you know it.
Do I?
I left Sergeant Pruitt to finish my task and to go for help. Would I have let him die had a real mission been on the line? You're damn right I would have, because that's what I was trained to do, but the circumstances were different. I left Pruitt to aid him.
So what? You want a medal for good intentions?
I want you to speak with Colonel Ryan to reinstate me back into selection.
Hate to break it to you, son, but selection is over.
Then I think someone owes me an apology.
How long you been in the Army, boy? Hey, Mac. Sergeant Brown here wants an apology for being mistreated.
Okay. Sorry you were mistreated.
Feel better now? This ain't no book club, Brown. If you want to be coddled and petted, you better go home and see your wife.
How did he die?
Who?
Pruitt.
Oh, you want to know how Pruitt died?
Infection? Kidney failure, heart attack? Because when I left him, he had a broken leg. Maybe. How did he die?
He didn't die.
What?
He was discharged from the hospital yesterday. He's back at Fort Benning now.
You lied to me?
Well, yeah.
You let me feel personally responsible.
How about that? Does that make you sad?
Our job is to make you fail. Only the few that get by us are fit to be in the unit. You think I'm going to put my life in the hands of someone I can outsmart? Someone who's going to fold when things get a little dicey?
How many got in?
I don't think that's any of your concern.
Four.
Can you tell me who?
You got that list of those we're supposed to notify?
Groninger.
Groninger, I ran laps around him.
He listened to Colonel Ryan. You didn't?
Colonel Ryan? What?
What did Colonel Ryan say?
What if I told you because of your mindset you were out of salute? It was a question. It was a question, not a statement. I took myself out.
Oh, is that what you did?
No one accepted my withdrawal. No one said it was accepted, and... and I completed the course, so...
I'm listening.
So I just passed selection?
You have now. Welcome to the unit.
Alona. Alona.
Sorry, you're too late.
Too late?
Bob's gone.
Honey, I'm right here.
He was in the unit, you know. They're giving him a special award.
Why?
For showing such bravery before he died. And you know what the hardest thing is? This terrible thought that I can't get out of my head. Because I know Bob didn't want to come home. Because he always got whatever he wanted.
Kim. No, don't cry, please. Please don't cry.
Thank you.
Alone. Alone.
Alone.